Good morning. My name is Kate Ferry. I'm the AFP's Commander of Investigations in Eastern Command. I'm here today with my police colleague from New South Wales Police, Detective Chief Superintendent Jason Weinstein. On Tuesday, the AFP arrested five men in rural and central Queensland after we had intercepted a black flight we allege was carrying over 50 kilograms of meth from Papua New Guinea into Australia. We allege the men were part of a transnational serious organised crime syndicate who were attempting to establish a supply chain into Australia of illicit drugs through Papua New Guinea. The men have all been charged with importing a commercial quantity of methamphetamine and face a maximum penalty of life imprisonment. We will allege the men had been meticulously planning this operation for months to fly an unregulated black flight from New South Wales into Queensland, from Queensland into Papua New Guinea, into a remote area of Papua New Guinea, and returning with a fuel stop in Queensland. What they didn't know, however, is that law enforcement had been tracking these people for this same period of time as part of a joint operation between the Australian Federal Police, New South Wales Police, and the Australian Criminal Intelligence Commission. In simple terms, an unauthorised flight is designed to avoid law enforcement detection. Black flights can involve logging false or no flight plans at all, flying at very low altitude, or turning off flight monitoring systems. In this case, the aircraft was flying at very low altitude and had its transponder turned off. For obvious reasons, this is a very dangerous adventure for other aircraft that are in the air, but also for the people on board themselves. These men have not only allegedly imported a dangerous drug into Australia, but flying at low altitude without proper instruments poses a huge safety risk for other aviation aircrafts. The AFP, with the assistance of Queensland Police, arrested the five men at an airstrip in Monto, which is about 450 kilometres northwest of Brisbane. We will allege that three of the men provided ground support, had staged themselves in Queensland since February. These men allegedly drove from the Hunter region in New South Wales, towing a trailer full of 1,000 litres of aviation fuel to allow the flight to return back to New South Wales. The methamphetamine in this operation has an estimated street value of $15 million. This investigation is ongoing, and further inquiries are continuing into how the syndicate sourced the drugs, who was responsible for organising the drugs, and also who was responsible for financing this venture. The AFP's International Command is working really closely with police in Papua New Guinea and authorities across Southeast Asia to further this investigation. The Papua New Guinea police have advised us that they now have one man in custody, a 42-year-old Chinese national who is currently being questioned in relation to this matter. Let me make it clear. The AFP is serious about stopping organised crime syndicates using the Pacific as a drug highway into Australia. These type of large drug importations undermine our national security, economy and the social security systems. The profits from illicit drugs are among tens of millions of dollars being laundered back into our financial systems every single day, further increasing the wealth of organised crime. This is why the AFP will continue to have a very sharp focus on targeting the importation of illicit drugs into Australia. I'll now hand over to New South Wales Police.
Thanks, ma'am. Officers attached to the State Crime Command of New South Wales Police Force commenced investigations supporting the AFP in regards to what was called Strike Force Red Ground for New South Wales Police. Our efforts included technical capabilities and logistics and support of targeting persons from New South Wales who were part of this criminal enterprise. Obviously, the great arrest that occurred yesterday is testament to the work and collaborative efforts that go on across law enforcement in this country, not only within New South Wales, but the wider jurisdictions, to stop illegal and harmful narcotics from entering New South Wales, in Australia in particular. If you look at the size of this attempted importation that was successfully stopped, you're talking about 520,000 individual hits or deals that would have potentially impacted the community, certainly within New South Wales, but potentially across Australia. As Ma'am Ferry says, that there are obviously investigations ongoing into where those drugs were ultimately destined for. We can see the impact not only in regional New South Wales in particular. So, you know, wastewater data from the ACIC showed that methamphetamine, or ICE as it's commonly known, is a scourge in this state, but certainly in regional New South Wales, where it really is tearing families apart. So it's not only the users that are impacted on this, there are communities who were seriously impacted, families torn apart, seeing their loved ones succumb to the scourge of this hideous, insidious drug. I guess the message for those who wish to be involved in this criminal enterprise is that you will be caught. The efforts, combined efforts of all law enforcement in this country, are certainly targeted to stop the harm from being impacted on our communities. So investigations remain ongoing, and the last part I want to say is that, you know, we have seen an escalation of some violence inside New South Wales of recent times, and it's fairly well reported. The central part of all of the crime that occurs in New South Wales, in particular around violence, goes back to drug supply. So my message to people who think that the deal that they take on a Friday night at a pub is okay and has no consequential implications for families and the community at large, you need to think again. You are all supporting organised crime in one facet or another. Now, there are treatment options out there if you are addicted. You need to consider those, because we need to stop this insatiable habit of our communities for this drive of drug, because these are the consequences that flow from it. Thank you, ma'am.
What can you tell us about the five men? How did they know each other? How long had you been tracking them? Did they work in the aviation industry? What details can you give us?
Yeah, so three out of the five men are closely linked to the aviation industry and have been within the aviation industry for a long time. They are connected through the criminal enterprise. And we've been tracking them for months and months.
Are they all Australian nationals, the men who are involved?
Yes, they're all Australian nationals.
Can you tell me a bit about what the men were doing to try and avoid detection?
Yeah, so they were obviously not buying that amount of fuel in a regional and remote Queensland community, so they were transporting that fuel that was needed to refuel and get back to New South Wales, all the way from the Hunter region up to rural New South Wales, rural Queensland. So they also had, one of the men was found with 17 phones. They were using encrypted devices, but they were also using lots of different mobile phones, and then what we commonly refer to as burner phones. So they were using traditional organised crime methodology to disguise their activity.
When did they actually go dark? When did they switch off the transponder and start flying
low? From the moment they left.
From Wilton?
Correct, all yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
And they were headed back to Wilton?
Oh, no, sorry, from Queensland. Yeah, from when they flew from Queensland to Wilton, from Wilton to Monto in Queensland. They left Monto at midnight on Monday night, and that's when they turned the transponder off.
Can you say why these drug syndicates are using PNG for staging around?
Look, organised crime syndicates will use any and all staging grounds to get drugs into Australia. We see it in a lot of Australian neighbouring countries. Papua New Guinea is just another example of why they're using, you know, the end result is to get the drugs into Australia. Obviously, Papua New Guinea, by its location and proximity to Australia, is very close. So they use that as a staging point for drug importation into Australia.
How long were these men on your radar?
They've been on our radar for a long time. So we've been watching them planning this, and they had made several attempts to fly to Papua New Guinea. So we watched them through that entire time, collecting evidence.
And when they were up in Queensland, you say they've been there since Feb. Is that when they were making the failed attempts to go? Do you know much else about their activities while they were there, what they were doing for those, say, 6 weeks?
Yeah, so they were scouting rural airstrips. So they had a number of different airstrips identified, and they were looking at different possibilities of where they would refuel.
Okay.